From verse number 7 of 2 Timothy chapter 4, verse number 7b, I have finished the race. The late Right Honorable Sir Mekere has run his race of life for the last 74 years of his life. He has run it well, and he has finished it well, because he has completed the assignment of leadership and nation building that God has assigned him to fulfill in his lifetime and generation. He has finished it well. So he has finished his race well. The question that we need to seriously ask today, as we remember and as we reflect and celebrate the life of this great leader, will we complete our God-given assignment, and will each one of us finish our race well? Finally, the final lesson that I want to draw our attention to is in verse number 7c. I have kept the faith till the end. The late Right Honorable Sir Mekere Morauta had faith in God. It was his faith in God, his trust, and his confidence in his God that enabled him to achieve great results in all that he did and that he endeavored to do in his life. His faith in God caused him to be humble, to be courageous, and to be a visionary reformist leader in our nation. So today, as we celebrate his life, we celebrate and bid farewell to a leader who has a personal faith in God. So our challenge today, as we conclude our homily, is this: will each one of us keep our faith in God through till the end of our journey of life? I am pretty sure the late Right Honorable Sir Mekere Morauta kept his faith in God right till those precious moments of his life where he had crossed over to a higher life and has been promoted to a higher home and a higher plane with God and with millions who have gone before us. Today, as I conclude this encouragement for all of us as we reflect on the life of the late Right Honorable Sir Mekere Morauta, our great leader and senior statesman, the question that all of us need to take home and ask is this: will you and I finish our race well? Late Sir Mekere Morauta has finished his race well. May we, too, who have gathered here today to bid him farewell, be challenged to finish our races well, so that we can leave behind a legacy that others will remember us for the way in which that God has been able to take our one lives, our time, our talent, our treasure, our experience and our expertise, and use it for nation building, for his glory. To God be the glory, great things he has done. And we all together say, Amen. We now prepare for the laying of the wreaths. As we prepare for the laying of the wreaths, during the laying of the wreaths and final paying of our respects, the Torepi choir and also the Hula Perverta groups will continue to sing as we come to lay our wreaths. So the procession will begin with the Honorable His Excellency, the Governor General of our nation, Sir Bob
and then followed by the Prime Minister of our nation and members of our former Prime Ministers, and also followed by the members of our National Parliament, and then followed by the Diplomatic Corps. So if I can invite the Torepi Choir and the Fula Prevata Group to start singing as we prepare for the laying of the wreaths. Thank you.